Online forms are the most effective and easy method for collecting data. Now, if you have a website, it's a no-brainer. You should have at least one form to get responses and prompt people to engage with you or your business. Now, embedding these forms onto your website shouldn't be a hard task either that requires you to get in contact with your tech friend. So if you want to learn the easy process of how you can embed your form by yourself right now, here it is. G'day everyone, Alex from the support crew at Paperform, and today we're going to take a look at how easy it is to embed your online form onto your website. Now, there'll be times where we want our forms to appear differently, perhaps as a standalone page, maybe with other elements on a specific web page, or even as a pop-up window that appears programmatically or when somebody clicks a button or an element on your website. So we're going to take a look at these various methods and anything else we should note when embedding an online form onto your website. For the sake of this video, I've created a simple contact form using Paperform. Of course, next, I need to embed it on my website. Now, because I have so many Paperform users asking how they can embed their online form onto their Wix website, we'll run through this process first, mainly the inline and pop-up methods, briefly taking a look at the full screen method as well. Now, not to worry, because we will touch base on how you can embed your online form on Squarespace, Webflow, WordPress, and Duda. However, it's best to note that embedding a form onto any website platform builder or any HTML source is the same process. So let's get into it. Now, from the form editor, we're going to navigate to Share and select Embed. We'll then see the embed methods we have available: inline, full screen, or pop-up. Each of those has a correlating code. So you'll want to copy the code of the method you want to use and just paste it into your website. For this example, I'm going to use the inline embed method. Copy your code, then jump into your Wix or website editor and navigate to the place where you want your form to appear. I'm going to navigate to a blank space I've already created. Now, it is time to add an element, specifically an HTML element or HTML block. Other website builders may reference this as a code block or code widget. We can add an element by selecting this icon here or the add element icon from the side panel. Navigate to embed code, then you want to select embed HTML. Next, you'll need to enter the code you copied. So we're just simply going to paste that, then click update. Now close the window and ensure that you resize your HTML or code block so that the submitter can actually view the entirety of the form. Scroll down and boom. Now hit save and view the live view of your website by clicking preview. Voila. We can see that we've successfully embedded our form. However, what if you wanted to follow the full screen embed method? That is, you want your form to appear as a standalone page, much like it does on Paperform. If we jump back to the editor, we'll note that some website platform builders don't actually support this full screen embedding. So a workaround would be to simply resize your code block or HTML block so that it appears as though it is full screen. Okay, we've taken a look at the inline and full screen embed method. Now let's take a look at the pop-up method. Sometimes you'll want your form to be hidden until someone clicks a button or element within your website, or you don't want it to become visible for a standard set amount of time. We do this with the pop-up embed method. Now let's jump back into our form and grab that pop-up embed code, head back into Wix. Let's edit our current code and replace it with the newly copied example. Hit update and boom. The form has now been replaced with a button that reads, "Click me to show the form." Now, I don't expect that the default design of the button emulates that of your brand or business. However, a basic understanding of CSS will help in changing the appearance and even the placement. Firstly, you can change the text of the button by removing that default text there and replacing it with your own. Now let's change the placement of the button, as well as the width, the height, and I also want to alter the button's color. Much better. Now, you can also enable your form to appear or pop up from other elements on your website, as long as you have an understanding and include the code within your website itself. Let us know in the comments below if you want a video detailing this process. However, be sure to check out the description because we've placed our embedding guide, which explains this process there. Now that I've made those changes, let's jump to the live view of our website and ta-da. I told you the process is easy and simple. Embedding your form on Squarespace is even easier. Let's hop back into our form editor and again grab that inline embed code. Please note that the full screen embed code simply won't work on Squarespace websites. Now, on your Squarespace editor, navigate to where you want the form to appear. Make sure you are in edit mode by selecting edit from the top left corner of your window. Select add block once it appears, then search for code. Make that selection, click the edit icon, and again, paste your embed code. Unlike other website builders, sometimes Squarespace won't allow you to see your embedment until you view your website in live view. Let's save that, take a look at it live view, and voila, how nice is that? Now we've looked at Wix, we've looked at Squarespace, let's take a look at Webflow. Although if you are using Webflow as your primary website builder, this should be an absolute breeze for you and I don't expect you'll be needing my help. With that inline embed code still copied, I'm going to navigate to my Webflow editor. Now, you want to ensure that you're on the page you want your form to appear. On the left sidebar, click the add icon and navigate down until you see embeds. Then, all you need to do is paste that embed code from your form in place of the HTML. Click save and close. And again, we'll need to save our website and take a look at the live view of it. So I'll click publish, open it up, and boom, we're flying through this tutorial. Now, before I let you go, I quickly want to touch base on WordPress and Duda. While you can follow the standard embed method for both of these platforms, they also offer a plugin. WordPress's plugin will allow you to easily paste the form URL of your form and it will obtain that iframe and then display it within your website. While Duda actually has an inbuilt Paperform widget from which you can manage and create forms and easily insert them into your website. Furthermore, if JavaScript does not work for your website platform builder or HTML source, have a look at the iframe fallback method. I'll be sure to leave a link to this in the description below. And that's all we have time for, but I'm eager to learn what is your preferred website builder. Personally, it has to be Webflow. The intuitive editor and versatility of the platform makes it a clear winner. Now, if you have any questions about embedding your form or anything else related to Paperform, make sure to leave it in the comments below. And if this has been a helpful video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe for more helpful videos. Good luck and have fun embedding.